Now second we discuss about electric field on equatorial or transversal position. So here is given figure. So figure is, in this figure is, we can see that the plus Q charges and minus Q charges are nothing but it is an electric dipole separated by distance 2a. So the equatorial here, equatorial line or transversal line is, see this pink line, okay, the bisector of this triangle, that is nothing but it is equatorial or transversal line. So we want to find out electric field on this line or any point, okay, or anywhere but in this line, okay. So suppose we take one point on equatorial line, say P. So we want to find out the electric field at equatorial line at any point, say P, randomly or arbitrary, say P. So the electric field due to the charge plus Q at the point P is given by E plus Q. Why? Because it is repulsive force. So we can see that from the figure, from the plus Q charges, the electric field produced at the point P is E plus Q, and from the minus Q charges, the electric field produced at the point P is E minus Q. It is radially inward, and from the plus Q charges, the electric field, it is outward because of repulsion or, okay. So the resultant electric field of E plus Q and E minus Q is nothing but it is vector capital E. So the resultant we can find out from the law of parallelogram, okay. Now we can find out the electric field at point P due to the charge plus Q and due to the charge minus Q, okay. So let us start or see one by one, okay. So electric field from the plus Q, or electric field at point P due to the plus Q charge, okay. So here E plus Q is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught plus Q upon, so the distance between plus Q charges and point P is this line, okay, see this line. So this distance we can get from the law of Pythagoras, okay. So here we get the distance between plus Q charges and the point P is r square plus a square raised to 1/2 because of Pythagoras theorem. Here is Pythagoras theorem is applied, that's why, okay. So here we can write the distance between plus Q charges and point P is r square plus a square into 1/2 and whole square. So square root and whole square is cancelled out, okay. So we can get finally 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q upon r square plus a square. Similarly, electric field at point P due to the minus Q charges, okay, minus Q charge, okay. So here is E minus Q is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q upon. So here similarly we can get result, okay, r square plus a square raised to 1/2, okay. So here r square plus a square raised to 1/2 over r square, okay. So square root cancel out, so same we get result from the above, r square plus a square, okay. So from here is equation 2, equation 1. So we can see that the equation 1 and 2 are both are similar. So resultant we get, so here we get from equation 1 and 2 same result. Okay, so we can write total electric field at point P is E plus Q is equal to E minus Q. E is from equation 1 and 2. We can write 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q upon R square plus A square. Okay, so this is our final conclusion or result. Now write down all this stuff. Now here we get the magnitude of the electric field at the point P. But what will be the direction at the point P? Okay, so let us find out. So here is plus Q is given. So we can take two components of this plus Q electric field. Okay, so here is two component. One is horizontal and one is vertical. Okay, suppose here is angle between these two line is theta. So here is also theta. So here is theta. Now here we take two components of the electric field at point P from of E plus Q and E minus Q. So E plus Q component is, one is horizontal and one is vertical. So theta here is given, and suppose we assume that here is also theta, that is nothing but it is 60 degree because of triangle. Okay, so theta here is also theta. Okay, so the component of E plus Q is, one is horizontal component that is horizontal component is E cos theta, and second one is vertical component, it is E sin theta. Okay, here is E sin theta and here is E cos theta. Okay, similarly we can write the component E, the component of E minus Q. Okay, the component of E minus Q is, first one is horizontal component is so see this horizontal component here. Okay, see this. So here is E cos theta and the vertical component so here is vertical component. Okay, see this for this E minus Q, the horizontal component E cos theta and vertical component is E sin theta. Okay, now it is clear from the figure that the vertical component of the E plus Q and vertical component of E minus Q are opposite to each other, so they will cancel to each other. Then we get final electric field direction E is equal to horizontal component only. Okay, so that is adding together, then we get 2E cos theta. Okay, so that is our final equation. So it is clearly from the figure that the resultant component of E plus Q and E minus Q at the point P is nothing but it is the addition of horizontal component and vertical component. But here vertical components are cancelled to each other, then we only add horizontal components. Okay, that is nothing but E cos theta plus E cos theta, it is 2E cos theta. Okay, so here we can write E from this equation. Okay, that is 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q upon R square plus A square. Then cos theta is, the value of cos theta we get from the figure here. Okay, so cos theta is base upon hypotenuse. Okay, so base here is given A and hypotenuse is nothing but R square plus A square
रेस टू 1/2. सो हियर वी गेट 2aq ओपन 4 pi epsilon नॉट. हियर इज 1 प्लस 1/2. देन वी गेट r स्क्वायर प्लस a स्क्वायर रेस टू 3/2. एंड वी नो दैट व्हाट इज 2aq. इट इज नथिंग बट इट इज इलेक्ट्रिक डाइपोल मोमेंट. ओके सो वी कैन राइट p ओपन 4 pi epsilon नॉट इंटू r स्क्वायर प्लस a स्क्वायर रेस टू 3/2. दैट इज आवर फाइनल इक्वेशन. Now here we assume that the point P of an equatorial line is very far from the electric dipole. We neglect a square in compared to r square. Then we get the equation this minus P upon 4 pi epsilon naught r raised to cube into P cap. So here the electric field direction at the point P, it is opposite to the electric dipole direction. Okay, see this, both are opposite to each other. See.
Now, we conclude that at the point on the dipole axis, we get the electric field E is equal to 2P upon 4 pi epsilon naught into R cube, when R is greater than A. Okay, and at a point on equatorial plane, we get electric field minus P from this equation, minus P upon 4 pi epsilon naught into R cube. Okay, when R is greater than A. Okay, so write down all these stuffs. Okay, thank you.